I will be demonstrating a yarn over. It is an increase that is used in knitting, and it is made by putting the working yarn over the right-hand needle to create a strand in between stitches that when knit over on the subsequent row, it then becomes a hole in your knitting, which is can be a lovely design element. So there are two different types that need to be done, depending whether the stitch following the yarn over is a knit stitch or a purl stitch. So to do a yarn over when it is followed by a knit stitch, I'll go ahead and knit this first stitch and show you how to do a yarn over when it's followed by a knit stitch. To do that, I simply bring my yarn to the front in between the needles. Basically, I have it in the purl position, and then I will knit the next stitch. Look at my right-hand needle. Here's the first stitch that I knit. And then here's my yarn over, followed by the knit stitch. So it created an extra stitch. It pretty much just looks like the yarn is draped over your needle. And when I knit over it, or purl over it, whatever my design calls in the subsequent row, it will create the hole. So I'll do that one more time. I'm gonna go ahead and knit one stitch. And now if my pattern calls for yarn over, knit one, I would go ahead and bring my yarn to the front in the purl position and knit the following stitch. There again, I have my yarn over followed by a knit stitch. Now if my pattern calls for a yarn over before a purl stitch, leaving the yarn in the incorrect position will not give you the same results. So to get the same results, you need to do something some patterns might call a yarn around, but a yarn over before the purl stitch, we need to actually create the yarn over with our working yarn. We bring the yarn underneath the knitting needle, counterclockwise, over the top and back to the front. So you can see that I have just wrapped that yarn around my right-hand needle, and then I can purl the next stitch. You see, now I have achieved the same results that I did with the yarn over knit one. Here is a yarn over purl one. I'll go ahead and do that again, but I'm going to separate it by a knit stitch. So here I'm ready to yarn over purl one. So I would bring my yarn underneath the needle and over the top so that my working yarn is in the front in the purl position. But I've created the yarn over by wrapping it around the needle. And now I purl the next stitch. And now I have yarn over purl. And just something to add to your little bag of knitting tricks, I'm gonna go ahead and show you what it looks like if I went ahead and just left my yarn in the knit position and purled the next stitch. You would think that would create a yarn over just like it did with the knit. But you can see that you get this kind of ugly looking double-legged mess. And now that is not what the yarn over should look like before a purl stitch. You can see that in a design such as this, when you have done yarn overs and worked past them, these holes can make a lovely design element, such as this pretty double diamond. Happy knitting!